Hey everyone, the topic for my RPP is San Diego Comic-Con International. So basically, what is Comic-Con? Or what are comics? Comics is a medium used to express ideas via images, often combined with text or other visual information. What is Comic-Con then? Comic-Con stands for Comics Convention, and it's a convention where comics and other related things get together and show off, and they also release new things. Comic-Con began in 1970 by a group of comic movies and science fiction fans Shel Dorff, Ken Kruger, Richard Alf, and Mike Torrey. The first Comic-Con event was known as the San Diego's Golden State Comic Minicon. The event was a one-day minicon on 21st of March 1970 at the US Grand Hotel in downtown San Diego. The purpose for this event was to raise funds and generate interest for a large convention. So these are the founders, Shel Dorff, Ken Kruger, and Richard Alf, and Mike Torrey. The success of the Minicon led to the first full-fledged three-day San Diego Comic-Con held on 1st, 2nd and 3rd of August 1970 at the US Grand Hotel. In this event, the founders included not only the comic books they loved, but also the popular arts that they enjoyed and felt deserved recognition. These are the few memories from the San Diego Comic-Con 1970. Initially, the show's main home was El Cortes Hotel in San Diego, but in 1979 they moved to Convention and Performing Arts Center and stayed there until 1991. And then after, they shifted to San Diego Convention Center. The convention is organized by 13 board members, 16 to 20 full-time and part-time workers, and 80 volunteers who assist the committee. The events that Comic-Con International includes are the traditional events include an electric film program, gaming program, and other programs such as cartoonist Scott Show's Oddball Comics Slideshow and other programming and on all aspects of comic books and pop culture. They also feature large floor space for exhibitors. These include media companies such as movie studios and TV networks. Academics and comic industry professionals annually hold the Comic Arts Conference at the Comic-Con, presenting scholarly studies for comics as a medium. In recent years, they have also started promoting number of films. During 2011 convention, at least 80 TV shows were represented, compared to about 35 films. High number of non-animated shows are also promoted by the studios and network. The recent one includes Bones, Castle, Nikita, Once Upon a Time, The Big Bang Theory, and The Vampire Diaries. Science fiction shows are also promoted, such as Being Human, Fringe, Lost Girl, Sanctuary, Torchwood, Doctor Who, and Warehouse 13. Apart from this, Comic-Con also holds different award ceremonies. The awards include Asher Awards, which are given for creative achievement in American comic books, Comic-Con International Icon Award, which is presented to individuals or organizations who have been instrumental in bringing comics or the popular arts to a wide audience, Inkpot Awards, that are given for their contribution to the worlds of comics, science fiction, film, television, and fandom service. The other awards includes Bill Finger Awards, which is given for excellence in comic book writing, Russ Manning Awards, presented to comic book artists whose first professional work appeared within 2 years, the Film Festival Award, presented to best short and long films, and the Masquerade Awards, presented to workmanship in the construction of the costumes and performances in the presentations. These are some of the exhibitors. So, looking at the commerce aspect of the Comic-Con, how does Comic-Con earn money? Comic-Con earns money through different mediums, such as selling the tickets for the event, through charities, movie and television promotions, by selling their own products during the event, by selling the comic books through participants, by its other events such as WonderCon and Alternative Press Expo, and by the rent paid by vendors using the space in the San Diego Convention Center. So, how much money does Comic-Con earn annually? Through various reports, it was said that Comic-Con brings in more revenues than the superheroes. A news reported that Comic-Con International almost brings nearly about $163 million annually. One report stated that the Comic-Con has nearly $10 million cash in the bank. The other forms of Comic-Con are WonderCon and Alternative Press Expo. Comic-Con Magazine. The Comic-Con Magazine, formerly known as The Update, was the official magazine of San Diego Comic-Con International, WonderCon and Alternative Press Expo, which was published in United States. Its main focus was of the winners of Asia Awards, and the last update was issued on July 2008. Update came back as Comic-Con Magazine, which not only covered San Diego International Comic-Con, but also WonderCon and Alternative Press Expo. The new Comic-Con Magazine features interviews with Comic-Con attendees and complete coverage of the Comic-Con events. The fourth issue of Comic-Con Magazine will be a hybrid with the Comic-Con souvenir book with cover art by Alex Ross in full color and exclusive to Comic-Con attendees. Comic-Con in India. Comic-Con India is the comic-based convention. Its main edition is held annually at New Delhi, and express editions are held annually at Mumbai and Bangalore. And for the first time in 2013, it was held at Hyderabad. In March 1970, 145 people attended the Comic-Con. Capacity attendance at Comic-Con in 2006-2007 has caused crowding issues. Concerns have been raised that the event is possibly too massive for San Diego Convention Center. In 2006, Comic-Con for the first time had to close registration for a few hours on Saturday to accommodate crowds. In 2007, the 3 days membership was abandoned and convention decided to sell memberships only in advance with no on-site registration. That year, all memberships were sold out before the convention for the first time. This led to sellout of the tickets on websites such as eBay and Craigslist. As of October 2013, 520 million proposed expansion to the San Diego Convention Center, which received approval from the California Coastal Commission. The proposed expansion will increase the available space within the convention center and has a target completion date of early 2016. The expansion will add approximately 225,000 square feet of exhibit space, an additional 35% and a brand new 80,000 square feet ballroom, which will be 20% larger than Hall H. The plan has also added a second tower to the Hilton Bayfront Hotel, adding 500 rooms adjacent to the convention center. Due to the proposed expansion of the convention center, Comic-Con has extended contract for San Diego to 2016.